Whether it be sonically, lyrically, or production-wise, there really isn't a science to why different music appeals to different people, because everybody's wired differently. One of my favorite musicians of all time, PJ Harvey, often crafts her songs out of fictional tales and lore, which can be fascinating, but for me, it's the clashing, distorted instrumentals and her vocal bravado that tear at my nerves and make me feel like I can conquer anything. People have the ability to find comfort and solace in music through instrumentals and lyrical themes, regardless of what's being sung about, and that's what makes music so relatable. I can still remember the first time I heard Elliott Smith's Between the Bars.
Drink up, baby, stay up all night, when the things you could do, you won't put your mind.
I was on a train home from school. I had just had a fight with my roommate, and was not in the right frame of mind to pretend like everything was fine. To hear him saying, drink up with me now, and forget all about the pressure of days, do what I say and I'll make you okay, and drive them away. The images stuck in your head. It felt reassuring, like having a friend. It sucks growing up in a generation that has a pretty bleak future, and for people my age to feel the world slowly collapsing in on us in times like these, it hasn't exactly been easy. My only solace, the one thing that's managed to keep me going, aside from my family and close friends, has been music. And it's always necessary to listen to sad music, music that is able to put words to exactly how the listener is feeling, especially on off days. It's the type of friend who will never abandon you. For me, in my late teens and early 20s, that band was Car Seat Headrest. Car Seat Headrest is a four-piece indie rock band that was the seed of an online presence frontman Will Toledo had on Bandcamp, cranking out albums that were recorded in the backseat of his car. The band was signed by Matador Records in 2015 and went on to release two acclaimed albums, Teens of Style and Teens of Denial. Teens of Denial is an incredibly important body of work in my life, because there was no other record I could find at the time that unabashedly tackled the apathy and cluelessness I felt about having to navigate early adulthood. One of the standout moments on Denial is Costa Concordia, on which Toledo compares his perceived failure to adjust to adult life to a sinking ship.
Stay up late every night, out of some general protest.
These lyrics really struck a chord with me, as a very young adult who had no idea what I was doing or how I was going to make the transition, especially when simultaneously going through depression and chronic anxiety. Will's writing is a stream of consciousness style that is multi-layered and complex, and at the same time, it's endearing, it's accessible, and relatable to the average listener, a balance that is incredibly difficult to strike. On the band's Bandcamp classic, Twin Fantasy, a concept album about youth, pain, existential disillusionment, and sexual confusion, Toledo's unorthodox vocals, coupled with a distorted clashing of instrumentals and production that invokes a lo-fi bedroom atmosphere, tells the story of a teenager caught in the throes of a complicated, tumultuous relationship. Toledo takes this stylistic approach and makes it accessible, completely subverting the listener's expectations and breaking the fourth wall by speaking directly to the listener whenever he describes his feelings of teenage angst, displacement, and sexual confusion. Twin Fantasy is so rich with multi-layered themes, references, and motifs, it's impossible to listen once and form any coherent idea of what he's talking about, and each listen allows the audience to turn over a new leaf. A favorite of mine is the 13-minute cut Beach Life and Death. What makes this song so relatable is the way Toledo touches on the ideas of exceptionalism and the lie that most kids are fed that their dreams are possible, when in reality it's not that simple. Will juxtaposes this existential disillusionment with some of the most mundane tasks imaginable, asking the questions, what should I do? Eat breakfast. What should I do? Eat lunch. What should I do? Go to bed. Where can I go? Go to the store. Where can I go? Apply for a job. Where can I go? Go to a friend's. Where can I go? Go to bed. This perfectly encapsulates the feeling that many millennials and Gen Z kids like myself have, having the misfortune of coming of age in a post-9/11, post-recession America. Not all of us can exactly afford to go off and do something revolutionary with our lives. Another main focus of the album is a failed relationship, and the fantasy Toledo has of shaping his partner into somebody that would do the same things for him that he would do for them. Many little motifs are referenced more than once, including grave sites, cigarettes, lying to people about being brothers out of fear of getting hurt for being in a same-sex relationship, and a star that appears every 1,000 years and causes instant pain the minute somebody comes into contact with it. All of these little motifs are in some way connected to key turning points in the relationship. It's a very extravagant way of confessing love and frustration, and to make an entire album about love, with writing that somehow manages to avoid cliches at every turn, is pretty remarkable. One of my favorite lines is, I pretended I was drunk when I came out to my friends. I never came out to my friends. We were all on Skype, and I laughed and I changed the subject. It's painfully awkward. You can feel the tension in Will's voice as he delivers this line, and I just find it so endearing because I've been there.
Extremely sad gay sounds. Meow.
Will Toledo is a bit of an anomaly. He has deliberately withheld information about his private life from the public, which was very smart of him to do, because it allows the music to stand on its own. The only opportunity his audience has ever had to have a glimpse into his personal life has been through his music. Other than that, he's remained relatively quiet. In the age of social media, it might seem very out of the ordinary for an artist to achieve this level of success without having built a persona to go along with it. Toledo has no problem citing the writers, artists, and musicians who have influenced his work, but he's never had a penchant for celebrity culture. I wanted my music to be heard, but that was really it for me, he said in a documentary about the band, going on to say, and that's a weird ground to tread, because these days it's a lot harder to get music to a certain point without becoming a personality behind it. It seems that the reason why he's been able to succeed in walking that line is because his music is strong enough to stand on its own. And as long as the audience forms a strong emotional connection with it, that's honestly the best a musician could hope for.